Mombasa, a melting pot of languages and cultures from all sides of the Indian Ocean, awaits travelers who make it to the coastline of Kenya. Mombasa offers alluring beaches, world-class resorts, relaxed and calm atmosphere.
And this is Mombasa, a city where the past and the present collide.
We're here to discover the staggering architecture, the natural beauty, and the inspirational places here in the city of Mombasa.
So let's go and explore.
Sure, let's go. Come with us.
We were charmed by Mombasa from faraway West Africa. And now we're here to explore it. The history of the city is a mixture of African, Persian, Arab, Portuguese, and British influences, which contributed to the rich cultures found in the city today. Historical ruins like Fort Jesus is Mombasa's best historical landmark and the city's most visited site. On hand to receive our team was a curator, Raphael Shem. Entry to the fort is accessed by walking through the towering walls and archways. This UNESCO World Heritage treasure was originally built by the Portuguese in the 16th century to serve as symbol and headquarters of their permanent presence in this corner of the Indian Ocean. However, today, there are chronological accounts of strong influences by African, Ottoman, Persian and British empires who fought to gain and maintain control over this strategic port.
Okay, now this is the chronological of events, how they happen. It started in 1593 when this fort was built by the Portuguese who were looking for a sail to India. And then after some time, it was captured by the Omani Arabs who came in after 100 years and they laid a siege around the fort. And later on, it became a government prison. So this was the first prison even before any other prison in Kenya. And later on, it became a national monument which turned up to be a public utility where now public could come in and see the history of Mombasa.
Wow. So, yeah. Awesome.
Wow.
On the roof of Fort Jesus is a battlement fortified with four coronades which were deployed to wage war against invading military forces.
One of the places we are visiting in Mombasa is Fort Jesus.
Fort Jesus is a military fortification built in the 15th century by the Portuguese.
Yes.
Yes, it's a beautiful place. It's hot, but we're enjoying every bit of the scenery.
Same
it's
here.
Beautiful.
That's history idea. Here.
Bye. Yeah.
Fort Jesus is important because most of the Mombasa history lies in this fort.
Most of the wars that were fought in this fort were to remain and retain the power of the rule of Mombasa. This fort, you'd say, when it became a barracks for soldiers, that was the last time that it got into use. Because after the soldiers, after Kenya got its independence in 1960, we can say basically that is the time that this fort now became dormant. But after some consultations with the Portuguese government and the Kenya government, they brought in some fund and restored it, and then it was opened up to people of the public to come in.
An important feature inside the fort is the passage of arches, a basement used for movement of slaves from cells into waiting ships during the slave era. In another section of the compound is a building housing a museum. It contains artifacts and ancient evidence of Swahili life and culture, as well as treasures from Mombasa shipwreck excavation. Fort Jesus, we moved to Bombolulu Cultural and Vocational Training Center, where we were accorded a grand reception by the host community. It was an amazing experience interacting with over 100 physically challenged artisans. We could not resist the temptation to patronize their high-quality range of jewelry, leather works, textile, and wood crafts.
I would want everyone to enjoy!
The main tourist attraction to Mombasa is its beautiful beaches. Jomo Kenyatta Public Beach, JKPB, is amazingly calm and boasts of fine, soft sand and calm water. It is a perfect experience for a fantastic vacation. If you love walking, swimming, or relaxing by the beach, JKB offers everything. Mombasa shoreline also boasts of many private beaches. Modern Mombasa is a city of great diversity and life. The city is a place where both history and progress are greatly valued.
Goge,
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 Goge, Africa,
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 Africa, Africa, Africa, Africa is the only thing I want to hear. It's the only thing I want to say.
Goge Africa is for Africa and it's about Africa. Goge Africa for Africa.
Coming up next is Sights and Sounds and Travel Tips. Don't go away. And on Sights and Sounds, we bring you From Kenya with Rose. Kenya is one of the biggest exporters of flowers in the world. Apart from exports, local demand for fresh-cut rose flowers are also high, mainly in Nairobi and Mombasa by street vendors and floriculture shops. Famed for being long-lasting, Kenya's roses are the main cut flowers grown in the country for export. They are loved for their elegant, pure white petals and used for varying purposes and occasions.
The people come to buy flowers depending on the time they want to use them. Now those people want to go to the funerals in the morning, so they come to the flowers in the morning. There are those who want to go and visit their friends in the afternoon. So flowers can be bought at any time of the day.
Kenyan roses are picked at just the right moment, custom packaged and transported that same day to arrive in all their glory direct from the grower. Cut rose flowers come in red, yellow, orange, pink, and white, symbolizing love, friendship, enthusiasm, gratitude, and purity, respectively.
Roses are in high demand because roses come in many colors, so they're easy to market, and people really love roses.
Today, there are many flower farms in Kenya to meet the increasing demands of both local and international demand.
Thank you.
hang on to Goge Africa because there is more to come on Travel Tips.
How to become a tour guide in your hometown. Tapping into tourism as a tour guide can impact on your income. Here are the beginner's guide to becoming a tour guide. Be observant and make researches. Taking note of what visitors find interesting can be fascinating, allowing you to see the seemingly mundane in a whole new light. Leave your comfort zone. Waking up in a hotel or bed and breakfast is a tried and true way to set the mood for exploring. If you live in a suburb, head into the city. If you live in the city, consider spending a weekend getting to know the next town. Make a date with your city. There are places you surely pass on a regular basis in your locality without paying much attention to them. I encourage you to set a date. Make a silent vow and check them out. You will be amazed at what you will discover. Act like a tourist. In order to understand the needs of a tourist, you need to act the part. Simply do as tourists do when they are in discovery mode in a new city. Take something small and make it bigger. Your daily stroll around the block could turn into a walk around a new to you neighborhood. Make it a mission to discover new things every time, and you will be surprised how simple shifts in everyday strategy can widen your window for adventure. Travel Tips was brought to you in conjunction with Goge Africa Travel Club and powered by Kenya Airways, the pride of Africa.
Aye, aye, aye.
Mombasa is a city with an ending experience.
And it's so hard to say goodbye to Mombasa. But don't you worry, because next time we might be going to Masai Mara. You never know. It's all here in Kenya.
And until same time, you'll be good.
Bye.